In the last video, we defined 7 topologies in the real line. Now let's start proving some of those inclusions I talked about. In this video, we will see that RF, that is the finite complement topology, and R sub R, the ray topology, are both subsets of the standard topology. Let's remember first what these two topologies were. RF is the finite complement topology, so it's formed by unions and finite intersections of sets for which the complement is either finite or is the real numbers. And the ray topology, I only mention the left ray because the proofs for the right ray, that is the ones A infinity, are very similar, is the one generated by these bases. Now, to prove these inclusions, we will use the lemma we saw at the end of the video about bases of a topology. I'm leaving the image of that lemma in the screen right now. So basically what we have to do is take one element in the basis of RF or R sub R, that is a neighborhood of some element in the real numbers, and prove that there exists another basis element now in the standard topology that contains the element X, and that is a subset of the other element we grab on the first place. So let's do that. Let's prove that RF is a subset of R. So the finite complement topology is a subset of the standard topology. For this, like I said, we have to take X in the real numbers and B in the tau F topology, in the finite complement topology. So B in tau F means that the real numbers minus B is a finite set. So we can just call it XI, just a sequence of numbers, but finite. So from I equals 1 up to some number M natural. So basically, if this is the real line and here I have X, my set B will be everything except for these numbers. So here we can have x1, x2, x3, and so on. Even some can be very close to x. But there's just a finite amount of these numbers. So I can always find a very small interval here. And this interval is the one that will be a subset of B, and that is in the standard topology. So what I can do is take advantage of the metric that I have in the real numbers and take epsilon to be a number smaller but positive to the minimum between X and XI, for I a number between 1 and M. So I'm basically just calculating all these distances, then I'm taking epsilon to be the minimum of these distances, and I can just take the interval X minus epsilon, X plus epsilon. This is an element in the standard topology T, that is the topology of the real numbers, and it's obviously contained in B. So it contains X, that is trivial, and it's also a subset of this set B that I grabbed, because it simply is way smaller. I mean, it has none of these X of I's, and it's bounded. B is not bounded. B would be all this. So it's everything except those little numbers. So it obviously contains my purple interval. And so we were able to prove what the lemma tells us to, and so we have that the finite complement topology is a subset of the standard topology. So with this, we have proven this inclusion. But one thing we also have to prove is that the standard topology is not included in the finite complement topology. So for that, we will again use this lemma, because the lemma was an equivalence. But now this is going to be very, very simple. So let's now prove that R is not a subset of the finite complement topology. So now, to negate the lemma, I have to grab a specific X and a specific neighborhood in the standard topology and say that there are no elements in the finite complement topology for which we have the inclusion. So we can just take 0 to be X. This is obviously a number in the real line. Minus 1, 1 is a neighborhood in the standard topology of 0. But there doesn't exist B in the lower limit topology such that 0 is a subset of P contained in the minus 1, 1. This cannot happen. Why? Well, it's very simple. Let's suppose there is. If such B existed, then we would have from here that the minus 1, 1 complement is a subset of B complement. This is just basic set theory. But the minus 1, 1 complement, this set is the minus infinity 1 union, sorry, minus 1 union 1 infinity. But B complement, because B is in the finite complement topology, this is finite. And this other set clearly is not finite, so this would be an absurd. This proves that such B cannot exist. And so we have that this inclusion does not happen. Now, let's prove that the ray topology is a subset of the standard topology. We will use again the lemma. You can see now how useful the lemma is. As before, we will take X, some number in the real line, and a neighborhood of X in the ray topology. So the ray topology, again, I'm using the left ray. You can do the same for the right one. So take minus infinity A, some set in tau ray, such that minus infinity A contains X. This means that A is again greater than X. So let's make the drawing again. Now, if I grab here my X, my neighborhood of X in the ray topology has to be something like this. So now it's even easier to see that there is an open interval. I can just take some number here and the same A or smaller, I don't care. I just want an open interval that contains X and that is contained in the minus infinity A. And that is very easy to get. So for this, what I will do is just let epsilon be some number positive. Then X will be an element of the X minus epsilon A, and this obviously is a subset of the minus infinity A. And so we have the inclusion that we wanted to prove. This is again using the lemma. And like before, we also have to prove that the standard topology is not a subset of the ray topology. But again, it's very simple, because one is bounded and the other one isn't, so you can probably imagine what it's like. Now, again, I can just take the 0 as my X and minus 1, 1, a neighborhood of 0 that's in the topology, in the standard topology. Well, there is no way I can get a ray inside this, so obviously there does not exist an interval of the form minus infinity A contained in the minus 1, 1. And this, I don't even need to prove it because it's trivial. And so that's it. This proves that the standard topology is not contained in the ray topology. I know it may sound very counterintuitive to prove this inclusion using the opposite inclusion over elements of the sets, but just check the lemma and you will understand why we are doing this. So with this, we finished this video and we have these inclusions. Now we need to work with inclusions in that direction. If you like these types of videos and you want to further support the channel, you have two ways of doing it. If you want to buy topology books, you can do that using the links in the description of the video to support us. And we also have Patreon links where you can find amazing merchandise. Or you can support us by buying t-shirts, math nerdy t-shirts, in our store.